We could play, say, from B, if I play from B to B, from B here, from here to here, I could play. This is one fingering, then I could do two, then I can do coming back here, this is three, then four, this is four, or four ways we have already, so we can do five, six, seven, eight, four, nine ways to do the same scale. So the four, of course we use three only in my method. We use three, but because Paco said, let's use three. Was a simple person. So therefore, simple-minded, I mean, you like to have also things simple, but again, this is based on knowledge. If you don't have much knowledge, you don't know how to move really well from in the fretboard, because in guitar happens weird things. Like when we are going this way, it should go up the pitch, right? Like, guitar, things happen like this, for example, how to demonstrate this thing would be, so I went that way and it sounds off. All these things are important to know, therefore fingerings is very specific thing, because you know, Satriani uses one type of fingerings, George Benson uses other fingerings, or Paco had also his own way to finger scales, which means this, the specific fingers with which we play the scales, and therefore you need to, even if you know other fingerings, I really advise you to take to the Paco's fingerings and learn how to use those, because it's very practical, those are very practical fingerings, and therefore this is very useful. So once you know that, you can use one scale or several scales and why. This why part here is very important, because when the band is playing one chord there and you want to get certain effect, you need to know why this is happening. How is it that this sounds less dissonant, not so much dissonant, and play with those, with the contrast of those elements there.
El loco que descubrí ahí es la improvisación. La improvisación es algo que yo pienso que cada músico debería, cada músico del estilo que sea, del clásico, del flamenco, de cualquier otra música, debería aprender, porque la improvisación te da mucha libertad y a la vez te da mucho conocimiento de dónde estás tocando y cómo estás tocando, de qué armonías estás en cada momento, ¿no?
Pablo.
Sí, Paco, ¿qué es para usted la música popular y qué es la música elitista?
Yo creo que la música elitista es el refinamiento de la música popular. Por ejemplo, el flamenco. El flamenco originalmente es una música popular, la música del pueblo andalucía. pero creo que ya no le pertenece más al pueblo, porque de pronto habemos gente que nos hemos pasado toda una vida encerrados, puliendo esa expresión popular. Entonces ha llegado a un nivel en el que el pueblo ya no tiene acceso, sobre todo a los matices que vamos consiguiendo la gente como yo, que nos pasamos muchas horas elaborando esa música.